Who is it?
It's me, babe.
Hey.
Hey, open the door.
Okay, give me 1 second, okay?
For what?
I got your gift out that I've been getting you for the wedding. I don't want you to see it, baby.
I know, baby. Give me 1 second, okay? 1 second, 1 second.
Partition, please.
Baby.
Drop and roll at the partition, please. I don't need you seeing your say on her knees.
Right now?
Yes, come on, baby. So I told him as soon as I put his gift, I was going to come get him to bed.
Girl, how many times you done did this?
Son, why? What's that matter? Come on.
Yeah, okay.
Come on, what are you doing?
Hey. This was fine.
Okay, baby.
We should do this again sometime.
Okay. Now go, listen. Go straight to the backyard and just sit back there, okay? Until I turn off the light in my room.
Right.
And I turn off my bedroom light, then you can go let me and each other, okay?
Alright.
Thank you. Listen, text me when you get there.
Alright.
Okay. Thank you.
Really?
What?
We spending all this money on an expensive wedding. And here you are buying me gifts.
Well, baby, come on now. You know I had to get you something.
See, that's why I love you.
Yeah, I love you more. Come on. Go take your coat off. You want a beer?
Yeah, I'll take
one. Okay.
So.
What?
You nervous?
About the wedding?
Yeah, you what, about 40 days out?
No, I'm not nervous at all. I'm actually just ready for it to be over with so I can enjoy it and enjoy you. And enjoy us, but no, I'm not nervous. What about you?
I'm a little bit scared.
Okay, scared or nervous? Because that's two different things.
Well, I say nervous.
Why?
Because I want to be the perfect husband for you.
Oh, baby, you are perfect. I don't have a doubt in my mind. If I did, I would not have said yes to your proposal. You're going to be great.
Can't believe I get to spend forever with you.
Together forever? Absolutely not.
Kendall, I just got one question.
What?
Why are you marrying this man if you can't see yourself with him forever?
You know what? That is a very good question and one that I don't have the answer to.
Oh, my God.
That's a great question.
This is ridiculous. You cannot go through with this. You can't marry him.
Kendall, don't you listen to her.
Are you serious?
Hell yeah. Watch this. Kendall, when's the last time you paid a bill?
Don't think I'll pay any bills since we've been together.
Car note insurance?
He takes care of that for me.
Okay, what about beauty maintenance? I'm talking about a mani and pedi, a massage, your hair.
He pays for that too.
Boom, I rest my case. And that is why she is going to walk down that aisle and I'm not going to let you or anybody else stop her.
No, Kendall, that's not right. I can't let you do this.
So what are you going to do, Lauren? Object at the wedding?
Why you giving me this?
So you can go online and fill out some applications. She's about to snatch your livelihood from you.
All I'm saying is marriage is supposed to be about love. Why marry somebody that you don't love?
Toni Braxton said you can learn to love anyone.
You're not helping.
Hell, neither are you. Look, you can listen to Lauren all you want, but I'm just telling you, Kendall. If things don't work out between you and Devin, he's fair game. You know I can't let a good provider go to waste.
Listen to what you just said. That sounds terrible.
Oh, Lauren, I'm sorry you feel that way.
Seriously, how would you feel if somebody you thought was in love with you was using you?
Girl, would you stop? You act like men don't use women.
The Bible tells us not to repay evil with evil, Tia.
And the Bible also tells us not to provoke others. And look at what you're doing to me now. Look, Kendall, all I'm saying is, don't allow Lauren to get you stuck in a situation you can't get yourself out of. Because I'm going to be honest with you. You know, you can't come stay with me. Mm-mm. I don't do roommates. I like to walk around my house naked.
Ew. What a terrible sight to see.
Don't hate.
There's nothing to hate on.
Okay, y'all two are crazy.
Oh, I didn't know we was having a party.
Because we're not.
Oh, so who was that?
I don't know.
Well, you going to answer?
I guess I should go.
Yes,
go.
She's crazy.
I know, right?
Hey, beautiful.
What are you doing here?
I thought I'd just come and surprise you.
And what a surprise it was.
Kendall, who is it?
My door. Mind your business.
You look great.
Thank you.
Kendall, who is it? Damn.
Nobody. Nobody.
So now I'm nobody.
Brian, come on. Please don't start this.
How you ladies doing?
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Brian. Nice to meet you.
Brian. Never heard of you before.
Ain't you lying. I'm not about to do this with you today. Come on, Tia. Let's get him some privacy.
I'm not ready to go.
Well, if you want to ride home, you better be ready to go, or you're going to be sitting at that bus stop waiting on that iron pimp.
You know what?
Come on, let's go.
Wait until I get my own car.
Oh, my God. I can't wait for you to get a car either.
Whatever.
Did somebody enjoy driving you around?
Whatever.
All right, Kendall. I'll call you tomorrow. Brian, it was nice meeting you.
Likewise.
Well, Brian, I would say it was nice meeting you, too, but I really didn't get a chance to.
Well, if you're a great friend of Kendall's, then I'm sure we'll be seeing each other again.
Oh, okay.
Girl, get out.
Oh, and before I forget, you two have fun and don't forget to wrap it up.
Okay. Bye. Thank you. Really?
What?
Pop-ups, baby. Come on. Now, what if Devin was here? Then what?
Then I would have started speaking Spanish and act like I was at the wrong house.
That's not funny.
I see.
Look, I thought we had an agreement. Pop-ups are off limits.
Look, I know. Look, I just wanted to surprise you, that's
okay,
it.
Hey, but that was not a good surprise, baby. You gotta stay in your lane.
Stay in my lane?
You know I didn't mean it like that.
So how did you mean it, Kendall?
Look, Brian, I'm just saying. I wanna keep doing this, but if we gonna do it, we gotta do it right.
Now, how do you suppose we do that?
By not popping up. You can't just show up because you miss me or you decided you want to see me. You can't do that.
Kendall, I thought you loved me.
Baby, and I do. I do.
So prove it.
How?
Call off your wedding.
What? What are you talking about?
You heard me. Call off your wedding.
Brian. You and I both know that I can't do that, okay?
And why not? Because we both know he's not the person you're supposed to be with for the rest of your life.
Okay, but it's not that easy.
So what you gonna do, Kendall, huh? You gonna walk down the aisle with a heart full of regret? Wishing it was me?
Baby, you know how much I care about you. I really do, but I'm not calling off my wedding. I already done said yes to this man's proposal. Everything is paid for. And I...
You what?
Nothing.
No, Kendall, what were you gonna say? Because I know you weren't about to say that you love him. Because if you did, I wouldn't be here. Now would I?
I can't even believe we're going through this right now, to be honest with you.
What did you think was gonna happen, Kendall?
I don't know anything but this.
You know what? Call him.
Baby, excuse me,
call him and tell him that the wedding's off.
I'm not doing that.
Maybe I didn't make myself clear. So let me do it now.
You're hurting me!
That wasn't a fucking option. So go in the room and pack a bag. Because we're leaving tonight.
No, Brian, you need to leave! You need to leave now, Brian! You need to go! You need to go, Brian! Come on! You need to go!
Oh, I will. But not without you. Kendall, I never wanted this to be so complicated. All I wanted to do was love you the way that you needed to be loved.
Brian!
But you wouldn't.
Brian!
You actually tricked yourself into believing that Devin was the one for you. But he's not.
Brian.
He can't love you the way that I can.
I know.
He can't protect you like I can. For example, what would your little brother boy do in a situation like this?
Brian!
Would he be the man that you think he is?
Baby,
and risk his life to save yours? Or would he be a coward and save himself? Because I know what I would do, Kendall.
Okay.
I would save my soon-to-be wife.
Save me.
Who's that?
It's Devin. He's coming over for dinner, baby.
get rid of them.
Okay.
Now.
Okay. Okay.
Hey, any funny shit? Okay. And I swear to God, I'll kill both of you.
Okay.
Don't fucking try me.
Hey, babe.
Hey, babe, what's up?
Can you please go to the store and get me some eggs, please?
Yeah, let me go pee real quick first.
Okay, but no, can you just get the eggs first, please? Because I really, really, really want to finish cooking your dinner.
Yeah, you got any eggs for dinner?
Cornbread. You know, you look...
Okay, well, you know, you've been acting kind of strange lately.
Probably just wet and jitters or something like that.
Oh, yeah, I guess. All right, I'll be right back.
Okay, thank you.
Let's go. We need to be gone before you get back.
Man, I cannot go with you. I cannot go.
Yet again, that wasn't a fucking option. Let's go. Pack a bag. Let's go.
Damn, Brian.
Hurry up. And give me your phone and turn your location off.
Location ain't off. You don't gotta do this. You know Devin and everybody gonna be looking for me.
That's fine. They'll never find you. Or should I say us? Hurry up.
Hey, I thought you loved me.
I do.
This is not love. That's impossible. This is not love at all.
Why not?
Yeah, you got a gun in my head getting ready to kidnap me. You think that's how I picture spending the rest of my life with my Prince Charming?
You gotta be so harsh, Cinderella.
Sure, I'll be playing it well soon, though.
Hurry up, let's go. Come on. Let's go.
Where are we going anyway?